So now we'll see the concept of data hiding, okay, through a practical example. So in our theory class, okay, as we have discussed, that we created a scenario of type student, and we took an example that we created a roll number, and okay, we have a constraint that this roll number cannot be negative. So what if, okay, if I just create a data member, okay, in the public part, and I just write int roll. So it means that this roll number is declared as public, and this data member can be accessed by anyone. Okay, so this data member can be accessed outside the class, or any function can access it. So what if, okay, if I just write int main, and inside this I'll just create an object of this student, for example st, and if I, okay, if I just try to access, okay, so you can just, okay, you can just imagine that there is some another user, okay, who tries to access this roll number now, because this roll number is, okay, declared as public, and anyone, any user can access it outside the class. So if any user, okay, tries to access it, and if any user, okay, by, okay, you can say by any so if any user try to access it, and okay, he assigns the value of this roll number as -30, for example. Okay, so this roll number is now -30. It means that the roll number has been accessed, and a data and a negative value has been provided, and that should violate our case. Okay, it should be that the roll number cannot be negative, as we know that in our class the roll number starts from 1 to n. It cannot be 0, it cannot be negative. But here this particular user, okay, has accessed this roll number, and it has provided a value negative to this roll number. And if this user tries to print, okay, this roll number, okay, and if it tries to, okay, print, retrieve the value, and if I just write st.rollNumber, and if I try to execute this program, so you will see that the roll number is coming out to be roll number is -30. So this is because this roll number has been declared in public section, it can be accessed by anyone, and the integrity of this roll number is at stake. Okay, this is the data member, and in integrity of the data, because anyone can access this roll number, and anyone can provide, okay, the value that could not be, okay, that could not be, you can say, justified. So what C++ has provided in order to resolve this, okay, C++ has provided a concept known as data hiding. So what we'll do, we'll just declare this roll number, okay, inside a private section. So implicitly, if we don't write anything, that then it means that all the data variables are inside declared as private. But we can also write, okay, explicitly we can also declare it as private. Okay, so this is a private access specifier, and now this roll number has been declared in this private access specifier, in this private section. So now we can say that this is data hiding. Okay, we have just hided our data from the outside world. So if any user tries to access this data from outside the class, then there should be, okay, some restriction from the compiler that this data cannot be accessed because it is local to this class. Okay, it is a member of this class only, it cannot be accessed by any function or any user. So let's try to compile this. Okay, so you can see an error has, okay, occurred that says that student roll number is private within this context. So this student is now declared as private. Okay, so we have, okay, we have provided, we have implemented, invoked this data hiding concept here, so that this data cannot be changed, okay, by any user that is outside the class directly. So here you can say this is the direct access. Okay, this was the direct access, and now the direct access mechanism is not working here because this data is in private mode. So how we will access this data now? So how we will access this roll number if it cannot be accessed directly? So there should be some mechanism so that this roll number can be accessed. So C++ has provided the concept known as member functions. Okay, so that's why these member functions should be declared in the public section. Why in a public section? Because they are acting as an interface to the data members. So now we will declare a member function inside public section so that this member function can access this roll number indirectly outside the class. So what I'll write, I'll just create a field, let us suppose set roll number, and in this I'll just declare int r. So I'll just assign the value of roll is equal to r, and I'll just print the message cout roll number, and here the roll number will be roll. So now what will happen, now the concept of member function is there, so this student object should invoke this member function. So now this set roll must be must come into the place, and inside this the value must be passed. So for example, if any user or any other programmer irrespective knowing that what is the logic behind this set roll number, because this set roll number has been written by us, for example, I am the programmer number one who has written the logic of this setroll, but the second programmer who wishes to access the roll number, but he didn't know, he has no concept that what is the logic or what definition I have written this, he is more interested in accessing this roll number function only, with the help of this setroll he wishes to access the roll number content, but he doesn't know that what is the logic behind this set roll number. So if unintentionally if he passes any value that is not you can say that is not accepted, so if he passes minus 40, so minus 40 roll number has been passed by that particular programmer in the function, so with the help of this setroll he is accessing the roll number. So what will happen, he will access it, he can access it because this set roll number now indirectly, this set roll number is indirectly, this is indirectly accessing the data members of its own class. So this data member, that is this roll, can be accessed by its own member function, that is setroll. So if I try to compile this, it will be compiled successfully, there will be no errors, but the output will be still a roll number minus 40, because we haven't written any logic or we haven't provided any constraint inside our function that if the roll number is negative or if the roll number is equal to 0, then this message should be printed. So if I just write inside this function definition that I have created, if I just write while r is greater than equal to 0, if this condition is met, then this roll is equal to r will be assigned and this cout roll number should be printed, and I'll just break this because I have printed this inside the while loop, so it will be printed in indefinite times, infinite times, so I have to put a break so that once a roll number is printed it should be, it should come out of the loop. And if this r, if this r is less than 0, less than equal to 0, then what I'll write, I'll just print a message that roll number should not be negative, it should not be negative, try again. So it should be a logic, it should be a logic that the programmer must follow. So this logic should be defined by the programmer number one, but the programmer number two who wishes to access this roll number, he doesn't know about this logic, his main intention is to access this roll number only. So if unintentionally, or if he tries to manipulate it, he passes some negative value, so this negative value should not be printed, in spite of this roll number roll number should not be negative, try again should be printed, so that he could know that he has printed some negative value here. So if I try to now execute this program, so this program should print, now there is some there are some errors here. The errors are, first of all, I have to close this particular function, Okay, now I'll try to compile it again. So it has successfully compiled and there are no errors. So if I try to run it, so it has, okay, it has printed the message that roll number should not be negative, try again. Now the logic is working correctly. It means that if the user is passing, okay, any negative value, so our function, our filters that we have written inside our function are working and they are checking the data so that the integrity of the data is not violated. The integrity means the roll number cannot be negative, it should have some positive value. So the integrity is not violated. In spite of printing the message that roll number is minus 40, it has printed that roll number cannot be negative. Okay, so in this way, okay, data hiding is implemented in C++, and in order to access the private data members of the class, you have to create a public interface, a public member function that can access the data indirectly. Okay, so I hope now it is clear to you. Thanks.